it's Purple Ace team here today. I'm gonna showcase the Phantom Knight deck profile that made it to the top cut of our Purple Ace Prograd tournament. So, let's jump into the list, and I think we should start.
And now, shouts out to our sponsor, the first one being Grad, the best grading company in Europe, which offers grading services in all languages and all OCG, TCG version of the card you might have or need, which is launching a brand new campaign that you will totally love. This is basically a new cover that fits perfectly the card without the need of a sleeve in order to see the beauty of your cards and to have an endless protection. Check them out. The second one is Squall and Loglan Gaming, which is a safe place to every YGO lover and player. Basically in there, they offer tournaments for money and not for money, just for entertainment, in every format you might want, need or desire. That's a great opportunity to improve as a player and also to make friends in the best community for YGO players ever made. And last but not least, we have Playmat per Tutti. They produce amazing custom playmats where you can send your own drawing or images, making it on your own and making the playmat your playmat. I've played with them. They are really amazing because they offer best quality for their products, and you definitely got to try playing with them. All our sponsors' link are going to be in the description down below, so don't forget to go check them out.
Starting with the going second card, it was playing, of course, 3 Blossom and Joy Spring and 3 copies of Forbidden Droplet. Really standard, and since this is a very heavy combo deck, it didn't have room for many going second cards. Then moving to the break of the deck, I guess, it was playing Wandering Nod, 1 Living Fossil and 1 Different Dimensional Reincarnation. So basically these 3 cards, Living Fossil and DDR, or they also may be Extender, and you can basically, you just send one of these with Isolde, you summon out the Renod, and the Renod, the other one you send with Isolde. So yeah, these 2 drawn by themselves, maybe extend, Renode just a brick, but it's very good for the combo. And of course, the brick, the best brick of the format, 1 Dark Magician, 1 Red Back Dragon, and 1 Red Fusion. Of course, the Dragoon package, it's really important in this deck. Then moving to the PK stuff, it's playing 3 Torrent Case, of course, the best PK, the one card combo itself. 2 Silent Boots, really standard, also an extender. 2 Clock, I guess for the grind game, the card is still pretty good. And just 1 Glove as an extra target for Bardic and Torrent Case. Then as 1 card combo, oh sorry, it's also playing 1 copy of Stained Griefs. This can't pass, but it's really good in some situation because it allows you to summon the PK as level 4 from your end. And this also an extra extender from the end, so yeah, pretty solid. Then as another 1 card combo, is playing of course 3 Tour Guide from the Underworld and 3 Kagemusha Knight to basically chain block the Tour Guide and get an extra level for level 3 on board whenever your Tour Guides get end up. Then as other extenders, is playing 1 Far Flint Lady, kind of spicy, but it's still a good extender to go into Isolde, 1 Psychic Wielder, which allows you to go into Kerubini instead. Then he's playing 1 Tsuchinoko, 1 Jackalop, 2 other very good extender to go into Kerubini, 1 Rota, which could search Kagemusha Knight and every PK monster, so that's really solid. And then he's playing 1 Egypt Cybers, just as an extra true guide or Kerubini target, basically to make them a free extender. Like if you draw Graf or Seer, you can just send someone to the door, so it's really, really good. Of course, he's playing Graf and Seer for the Kerubini combo. And last but not least, 1 copy of Call by the Grave to play around and tap better. Then the last cards of the deck are the tops. He's playing 1 Tusk, 1 Shadow Brigandine, sorry, which could be both an extender for Isolde or an extender such later in the combo to go into Anaconda or Apollos, stuff like that. And then, of course, 3 Fogred, very good interruption you can search with your PK engine. Then moving to this extra deck, he's playing, of course, 1 Eldritch Dark Dragoon. Just broken, really nothing to say about it. Norcrabaljaxis Dragon, basically an really good TK machine, it's kind of just insane going second. 1 Zeus, of course, in simply is playing many XYZs. 1 Lagarde Siege Dragon, 1 Raider's Knight, and 2 Bard, 2 Brexword. So 2 Brexword are probably placed 2 because he uses 1 turn 0 during the combo to pop itself and then summon back with using the Bardic loop. So in most of the times it needs another one for the following turn, and Raider's Knight is what allows him to go into Dark Rebellion, so it's really needed. Then moving to the links, it's playing of course 1 Hatchet Guard for the TK, 1 Apollosa for his final board, 1 Kerubini, 1 Isolde, which are probably the best card for the combo, his main 2 starters, 1 Nightmare Unicorn, in order to link an inventory access called 1x spider to play around the bureau in order to turn the token into an effect monster so that it can link it away for an averted account, of course, to summon a Dark Dragoon. And last but not least, probably the best card of the deck, one Rusty Bardage. This card was unbanned and this card is great. So, last but not least, the side deck. I was playing 2 copies of Dory Lockwood, 2 copies of Gamisiel, 2 copies of Lancia. So I decided to play 2 of each just to have a very flexible side against every matchup, and 3 Nibiru, probably expected many Salamence great. 3 Lightning Storm, 2 Twin Twister, and 1 Red Reboot, just 6 out of win buttons against drop decks. But I really need for the deck, because once you start your combo, you usually win against control decks. So guys, this is it for the list. Hope you enjoyed. The list was, I think it's very cool because it's playing also the round package, which is gives the deck a lot more gas and versatility. Hope you enjoy, see you next time, and remember to stay plus.